President Mohamed Ould Ghazouani and his predecessor Mohamed Ould Abdul Aziz are longtime friends who staged coups together since 2005. Aziz ruled as president, Ghazouani as army chief, then minister of defense. When Aziz completed his terms in office, he supported the candidacy of Ghazouani, who was elected in June. But their alliance came to a sudden end last week. Backed by a few loyalists, Aziz wanted to lead the ruling party, the Union for the Republic, which he founded 10 years ago. Ghazouani's supporters rejected the move, which they described as an attempt by the former president to sneak back to power.
Our position as majority in the administrative committee reinforces that this is the party of the government, so it should be run by the sitting president, Mohamed Ould Al-Ghazouani, not literally, but in consultation with all party members. As to former President Aziz, he can pursue his ambitions within the party like any other member, but he can't have a special status.
This is the first fragmentation within the ruling party since its inception. We now have two sides. One owns a majority of 22 members in the administrative committee. The other owns the leadership of the party.
Fears of a serious escalation increased after the arrest of the commander of the presidential guard and his deputy, two loyalists of the former president. As the country celebrated the anniversary of its independence, rumors spread out about a failed coup attempt. The sudden reappearance of the former president on the political scene coincided with the launch of a reform campaign by the new government. People here say the former president should be brought to justice for corruption and abuse of power.
The fact that they've reached this point now means nothing will stand in the way of reform.
Despite that hope, tension remains and there's uncertainty over what the next move of the former president might be. Since June's presidential election, there has been speculation as to who is really running things in this presidential compound behind me. Some have said that President Mohamed Ould Ghazouani might be under the influence of his predecessor, but that has turned out to be wrong. In a clear break with his predecessor's antagonistic policies, President Ghazouani made peace with all opposition leaders and invited them to work with the government for the public good. But there are fears that both the reforms and the national consensus that's being built may well be disrupted if the present crisis is not soon resolved. Mohamed Vall, Al Jazeera, Nouakchott.